So all of us know Earth is spherical in shape. It's not 100% spherical in shape. It is a bit flattened at the poles and it has a bulge all over its circumference at the equator. Okay, so this shape is known as geoid. Geoid is Earth-like shape. Okay, you have different geometrical 3D shapes like prism, you have cube, you have sphere, right? So this shape exclusively or Earth shape, okay, it is named as geoid, and geoid is, or the meaning of geoid is Earth-like shape. What is the proof that Earth is geoid in shape? Okay, so people have been observing different things, okay, over the years, and there have been some proofs, okay, there has been some study also made to prove that Earth is spherical in shape or geoid in shape. Okay, so let's just go through the evidences which prove that the shape of Earth is spherical in shape. Okay, so the first evidence is circumnavigation of Earth. Okay, so what happened is earlier the sailors, you know, they didn't venture deep inside the sea, okay, deep inside the sea or ocean, because they were afraid. They thought that sea was like a table and it had a edge, okay, so they would fall off the edge. Okay, so they imagined it to be something like this. Okay, so this was their boat, and they thought that after they would come here, they would fall down. But that isn't true, right? So what happened is, in 15, '19, okay, a sailor named Ferdinand Magellan, okay, with his crew, he started from a point in 1519, okay, and 3 years he kept on sailing, and in 1522 he reached the same point, okay, and he didn't observe any abrupt edge or something like that where he would fall. Okay, so after that, you know, sailors started venturing deep into the sea. They started exploring different parts of the earth, right? So this credit goes to Ferdinand Magellan, okay? And he went with his crew. So this is one more proof, okay? This is the first proof rather. And what it, you know, even today's latest ocean navigation and even the latest aircraft routes are designed assuming that Earth is spherical in shape. Right, so this is the first proof, is circular horizon. Okay, so if you are on a deck of a ship, you'll observe that you can, you know, the border of the sea, you can see it in a bit circular in fashion, like this. You know, this is the deck or something like that. This is a ship. Okay, if you view from here, you'll find it a bit curvature or something like that. Okay, this is because, so this is Earth, this is your Earth. Okay, this is your ship. You can even notice it when you're at a height. Okay, when you're suppose on a mountain or something like that. So when you're here, okay, this is your viewpoint, right? So from here, when you just view, you see this, you know, circular sort of horizon, right? But if our Earth would have been like this, you stand here, you can see everything, right? So, but that isn't true. This is the truth, right? You can see like this. So this is the second proof, okay? Okay, so what exactly is it? See guys, if our earth would have been flat like this, okay, this is the dock, and from here the ship has been undocked. So if you see from here, you could see the whole ship, and after a point still you could see the ship, but the whole ship in small size, right? But that doesn't happen. Earth is circular in shape. The ship may have started from here, from this point, or let's assume from this point. Okay, this is the center. When the ship goes like this, being circular in shape, this is called the mast. Okay, the bigger part is called the mast, and the smaller part is called the hull. So, from this point, slowly, after it travels inside the sea, what happens is you see only this part. Later on, when it goes deep inside the sea, you only see this part, and slowly the ship vanishes. Okay, so this is the reality, right? This is what you see. So again, this proves that Earth is spherical in shape, because slowly and steadily you see the ship diminishing. Okay, so again, this proves that Earth is circular in shape and not, you know, table like thing. It is sunrise and sunset. Now, what people observed is, at one place when there is sunrise, at the other place there is sunset. Okay, so if again our earth would have been flat, this is the sun. Okay, the sun rays would have reached all parts of the earth, right? But this doesn't happen. What people observed is, if there is sunrise happening here, you have sunset happening here. Okay, this can essentially happen only if Earth is circular in shape. You have sun on this side. This is not to the scale, huh? So you have rays coming here. Obviously, they would come till here. So here you would be having night. Okay, at this line you would be having either sunrise or sunset. So if you have sunrise here, backside you would be having sunset. If you are having sunset here, on the backside you would be having sunrise. Okay, so this is only possible if Earth is circular in shape. Okay. So without doubt, this proves that Earth is spherical in shape. So I'll tell you how. In lunar eclipse, what happens is, this is the sun, this is Earth, and this is the moon. Okay, just for demonstration purpose, I have drawn this moon to be so big, you know. So this is our sun, okay, this is Earth, and this is moon. So what happens in this scenario is, sun's rays fall in this direction and Earth's shadow get casted on the moon. Okay, so I'll just darken it for understanding purpose. I'll just mark it here. This is the moon. Okay, it could be like this, it could also be in in a ring shape, like, okay, depending on the distance of moon from the earth. If it's too close, you know, you'll find the moon to be cut like. If it's far, you can find a ring like shape. Okay, but the point here is, only a spherical object will have its shadow circular in shape.
Okay.
If Earth would have been square in shape, the shadow, you know, would have been something like this.
Right. But only a spherical object or spherical-like shape object can have a shadow that is circular in shape,
okay,
which we can see on the moon. So without doubt, this proves that Earth is spherical in shape, okay?
Is planetary bodies
are essentially spherical in shape. Now the reason I feel is, say suppose you have something of this sort.
This is a planet and it revolves like this.
Okay, it revolves like this. Now, when it revolves at a relatively high speed, what happens is these sides, because of stress concentration, tend to erode,
right? And slowly and steadily it tries to become spherical in shape.
Only because it revolves around itself.
So that is the reason why I said planetary bodies.
Okay, planetary bodies mean planets.
Okay,
and planets have a tendency to move around itself. So, all the planets are spherical in shape. So Earth cannot be an exception, right? So by analogy, Earth is also spherical in shape. So by observing other planets and observing that all the planets which have been found by now are spherical in shape, Earth is also spherical in shape. Okay?
Driving poles.
Okay? So you may have seen, you know, the people come and do the survey and all of the land.
So what they did is, you know, they started digging poles of same length after some distances. Okay, here, and they noticed that they were of different heights. I mean, from here, if they checked level of this pole, it should have been in one line, right? Because height of these poles is same. They have been dug also same, at the same height. But that didn't happen. Okay? So consecutive poles came to be at a level. So this again proved that Earth is sphere. If Earth would have been flat, then all poles would have come in one line. Right? But this, they didn't find out this. They found out that level of each pole was different. Okay? So again, one more proof. And now we have the last proof. I'll write it here. Aerial photographs. After the inventions of rockets and space shuttles and that sort of thing, when after launching these space shuttles and rockets, photos were collected of Earth from there, and that 100% proved. So this is a proof. Okay, this was an observation. So aerial photos undoubtedly prove that Earth is spherical in shape, because they click photos from the space. Okay, so this is our last and sort of important point. Okay, now guys, we have still some topics to be covered in this chapter. okay, which I would be covering in the next video, because this has been quite a long video, right? Please do like the video if you like, not a compulsion, because I don't get anything if you like the video. Okay, please do mention if you have any suggestions, okay, in the comment box below. And here, please click here. What I have done is, you know, I have 4 options kept for you: very good, good, bad, and very bad. So if please do click one of them, so I'll come to know how I'm teaching you guys. Okay, so that will help me understand how I teach you guys. So if there are any issues, please do mention in the comment box, so I'll try to improve myself. Fine. So let's meet in the next video now.